Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath,
everyone. Thank you.
Declare the Senior money. You are Simba Tebatu, you hate the sickle.
First, I want to introduce myself.
Yimini Bokoyala, Pooh Sandy.
People call me Pooh Sandy, Grandpa Sandy.
Yimini Kotikwene Bokoyala, San, S-A-N, San.
My first name is San, S-A-N.
Alokita Kwene Bokoyala, D-D-E-E.
My last name is D-D-E-E.
Bokoyala, Pooh Sandy.
They both will call me Pooh Sandy, Grandpa Sandy.
Zimiro. Timmy, Tammy, Puzzle, and more. This is why I have a phone thing on her.
If you get bored, you can contact me by phone.
Who's sending a book in the holiday? You would download your phone number 315.
This is where I live. You can contact me at
315-733-7-3-3-3-6-3-2.
The key.
You tell on 301.
This is my address.
Elizabeth Street.
The
apartment 212.
You will apartment key what? The
Utica.
Only Utica.
NY, New York.
New York, no, NY.
A zip code red alert 13501.
That is zip code Lamona.
The one is in the book of Sarkumala. Here at that point, yeah, there you go. Seek it to market derby. But when you're at that, see this, so back at all. The 2 years said, you are a little Macala, but what? Because what?
This morning, I'd like to thank God for giving me the privilege to finish on the Quran history, especially our book of silver and gold, and how it was lost and how God restored that book to us through our white brothers. Last night we heard about the story of the book of silver and gold and how it was lost, and again you also found out there who brought that book back to us. I just want to recap the story about the book.
I saw the America, La Miodala,
the first person who introduced us the Bible was Jason and his wife Anne.
I already had dinner, a copy on it, let the tow, copy at the sea, 30, La July, the sea, Luther.
They came to Burma on the 14th of July, 1813. They went through many challenges to introduce that book to us, but I won't mention much about the challenges this morning. At the time when Jason and his wife arrived to Burma, they were only 20 years old and they studied really hard to learn about Burmese language. It took them years to learn Burmese. Once they understand and they learn Burmese fluently,
however,
they were able to read. They were able to speak. They were able to translate the language from English to Burmese. Jason and his wife, they work in Burma for 37 years.
13年呢，啊，我那土佬啦，你说是黑了，格罗马土佬，那巴达国佬啦，伊比多，那来黑的多呢，土佬是比较困难，我来看了。So
during that time, they translated the Bible from the original language Hebrew, Greek to Burmese.
对面文化呢，阿克萨呢，让我把它看上。Once
they done with their translation, they started to spread the gospel.
要拍大伯生呢，知道有那是阿妈啦，阿咪苗啦，安呢，是为了这个土好个呀，其实好呢，没那打算打啥个事情，到这里不会把好呢了。In
1826, and that's the wife of Jason's passed away.
阿妈自己看呢，阿妈自己了，忙了咩不搞了，Jackie，是我哥的婆婆呢。
She passed away in Jaikami, close by Molamiyad, and they buried her right there. When she passed away, her husband wasn't around her. At that time, and her husband was in Ewa, close to Mandalay. When the husband received the news of her husband passing away, his heart was broken. They have one daughter.
Amila Marian.
Her name was Marian. Because of the diseases, many hardships that they went through, and her daughter, his daughters passed away too. At that time, there was another missionary. And his wife's name was Sarah. Sarah's husband, the missionary, also passed away at that time. Then Sarah remarried to Pastor Jason. In 1850, at that time, there were like 50 years of his work in Burma. Within that 50 years, the translation work, like the Book of Seven, had been completed in that time. Not even that they finished the translation, they were able to distribute that across the country. Because of the book of Seven and God, because God had blessed that book, and then he also saw the fruit of the book. Because of the book, you know, 5,000 people became Christians. Among those 5,000 Christians, there were Mon ethnic group, there were Karen, there were Burmese. Yesterday, Mrs. Priscilla mentioned to us the first Karen became the Christian was Godapu. Godapu wasn't interested in the religions when he was in the young age.
clever, me tell the Tony.
To be honest, he did not live a good life. I mean, he did not, you know, behave nicely. He just lived according to his heart. Once he was able to read, had the opportunity to read the book of Seven and Go, he converted in his heart, and then his behavior, his life started to change. Just like Apostle Paul. Just like something burning in his heart, he was on fire. He was really on fire for the Lord, and he was also known by another name. And when he beat a church. He beat the church. It was for two places. One is for the worship and gathering, and another one is just people to have a regular meeting. You know why he used the pole, the big pole, to beat the church? He used like 100 of them. So he was known as Goda Pyu, who beat the church using like 100 poles. Because of the book of Seven and Go, and then he became converted, and then he even built a church. During that time, Pastor Jason, he won like 5,000 people. At that time, he said, Goda Pyu also established his church already, and there's no longer this time for me to go back or to visit my country. In his heart, he said, I'll go back to my country, I'll just visit them, and then I'll return to Burma, and then I will die when my wife passed away. So then on his return back to Burma, and then he arrived to Kapali Jong, who was a place in Burma. At that time, he wasn't feeling well. In short, he passed away then. And we know that when he passed away, there were not many people around him, and those few people buried him in the ocean.
But they
He was the first American or white brother who introduced us, brought back the book, you know, the book of Seven Gold back to the people in Burma. And at that time, among them were Baptists, and the Adventists who hasn't started then yet. And once Pastor Jason went back to visit his country, the work, they started to distribute the book of the Seven and Gold. At that time, there were two brothers. They were not Burmese. They were not Karen. But they were Hmong ethnic group. At that time, there were no missionary around there. There were no one who could share the word of God with them. And they were studying the book of Genesis, and they found about Sabbath there. And said the Sabbath had to keep it holy, and that's trouble them. They found out that there were two brothers and sisters. So the sister found out about the Sabbath message as she studied the Bible. And then she shared what she studied from the Bible to her brother. And then once the brother studied about the, found out that message, what happens at that? At that time, he had a good position in his workplace. And then he was working on the Sabbath. And said, on the once he found out about the Sabbath message, and then he quit his job. And his name was Mama, and then once he quit his job, he kept on studying the Bible thoroughly. His sister's name was Dome. They were not
correct.
They were not Karen, they were Hmong ethnic group, and they were the first two people that found out about the Sabbath message. At that time, they were not Adventists, but they kept the Sabbath. And then there were two missionary literature evangelists that came to Burma. They were Watson and Mayer. They were selling books and they arrived to Mamon and Domi place. Because of the evangelist witness to them, and that time they became the Seventh-day Adventists, but they were not baptized then. In 1915,
in July,
there were another two missionaries.
Were
husband and wife.
Australia.
They from Australia. They arrived in Burma in
1915.
They were Pastor Eric Pihe or Pukore Rabbit Pu Badem or Pupadan, according to Pupadan, and his wife Mrs. Agnes. Once they arrived to the country, they learned about Korean people and they started learning their language. They learned Korean language thoroughly. They were able to speak in, you know, Korean language better than how I can express the Korean language. At the end of 1916, they moved to
Ondo Gamama.
At that time, they have the Bible in Burmese language and then there was Mr. Sid, and he translated in Korean already.
Now, the
And then Pastor Eric Pihe started the work there and started to share the gospel with many people. And the first person who became the Adventist was Pu Tha Myai. After that, Pu Peter, and then Pu Mia Bo,
Pu John,
and then Pu John.
We are paying the head of Pu Bo.
There were Pu Bo as well.
Pu Bo, I'm your pay, Pu John, I'm your
sister of pay. We have the relatives of Pu Bo, Pu John. Pu John is my great grandfather.
What are you getting with that? I'm moving to Pu, get out of the mind, you know.
And then they became, they were the first, I mean, they were, you know, a few number of Adventists who became the Adventists, and then they also became the ministers. I have a question. I want your response. The Book of Savor and Gold. Okay, we have two things. Okay, the Book of Savor and Gold and the missionary work. Which one is the most important? Okay, raise your hand if you say that the Book of Savor and Gold is very important. It's, more important. What about you say that the missionary work is important, is more important than, you know, the Book of Savor and Gold? I want to see
your hand.
I have something to share
with you.
In the Bible, one plus one, is that one? Did you find that answer in the Bible?
One
plus one is two, isn't it? In Matthew chapter
19 verse 6.
So then they are no longer two, but one flesh. So, a man and a woman, when they are married, they're no longer two, but one. So, I want you to think, the Bible plus missionary work, is it two or one?
Okay, thank you.
Thank
you.
because of the word, because of the Bible, and because of the missionary work, they are combined together. Therefore, you and me, we become the Seventh-day Adventists. We receive the gospel. So the word of God plus the missionary work is not true, but it's one.
Amen. Amen.